Hey guys, Dylan from the Geek Doer here, and today I'll be bringing you my reaction to My Hero Academia Season 4, Episode 20. This one's titled Golden Tips Imperials. Eri visits UA while the students are preparing for the school festival, and Gentle finalizes his plans. Now, again, don't have much of a pre-ramble. I'm gonna keep saying that because, well, that's basically what I do. It's what I'm doing right now, explaining it. So, let's get this started in 3, 2, 1, go. Oh, it's just a red singlet. Bend and snap. Oh my god, it's Eri and a peach. Yeah, for those of you who don't understand why I laughed at the start of this episode and the last one, a preamble, without the R, is like the statement or discussion like a formal discussion talk. So like the preset to like a court case starting, where I don't really know how to play it, but I tend to ramble before these episodes start and during the opening. So I took preamble and ramble and joined them together to describe what I tend to do, and assuming I remember it, I shall probably continue to say pre-ramble. Mirio would have just had to have crawled on all fours just to be that small compared to Aizawa. Why are you the way you are? Comments like that that make it obvious as to why I want to just punt him. Makes sense. That's two people that think that Eri is, that Mira has a daughter. Our school never had a festival to this scale. Like, we had a yearly festival where we all set up stalls, but we never actually really built things. Except, of course, if you count the school play, but there was only two groups that were working on that. That would be the drama and the woodwork, who actually did construction and set up for that. So yeah. Romeo and Juliet and the Fellowship of the Prisoner of Azkaban. It's ironic that a person whose quirk is to copy others has copied several famous movies or plays to put together. I saw a post earlier on Instagram that had the Owase holding the beam, saying it has the same energy as Mike Myers' Cat in the Hat when he has the baseball bat. Yep, her body proportion. I would have probably been the exact same as Midoriya with that. Okay, that was a very gay look from Yu Yu. I'll get into that later. Return of one of my favorite characters. I can see where she's coming from. Those seem like dangerous gloves to be wearing on a construction site. That's likely an electrical fire. You don't want to put water on that. One of my other favorite characters, Shinzo. Snap. If I was a little kid and I saw that, I'd probably be freaked out. understand where it's coming from. That's the thing I really like about this show is a lot of the points put forward by both sides of any disagreement, you can see where they're coming from. And then there's overall. My boycott dance. Where did she even get a suit? Did she like bring it with her or did she borrow it from someone else? It was Coda who had the courage to put forward an idea. He's definitely come a long way. I do like the look of females in suits. Fair enough. Just noticed that he always comes out of muscle form hunched over so that when he coughs, the blood doesn't go in his clothes. No, a week for chord progressions is pretty good. At least compared to most of my group when I was learning in year 7. Took some of them a full term, so 12 weeks. To even get a couple chords down. Ooh, 0 likes, 785 dislikes. 6,400 views, so that's something. Depending on his subscriber count, he might be raking in some revenue. I'm not in the room, I cannot hear you. Demo, demo, gentle. See, this what I mean. His basis is pretty much the exact same thing the police chief said. That in times like this, they shouldn't have the festival. They should be focused on preparing for attacks and training and all, just for general day and that. He's just taking it to the extreme and showing them that they're not prepared. Golden Tips Imperials. Now that sounds familiar, doesn't it? I thought so. never actually met someone who runs around in circles when they're excited. Into your account to find your actress. I'm calling the police, stalker. Yeah, I find it funny that gentle is as well. I wouldn't say inept, but has as little technological skills as he does because, well, they said at the start that when quirks appeared, technological and societal advancements halted for ages, and they seem to be at a point where they are further technologically advanced than we are. So, assuming they were on the same trajectory, they are several decades, maybe centuries in the future, based purely on technological. So, they would have had that much longer to learn how to deal with. So a 32-year-old not knowing how to unlock a locked folder on their computer. I mean, it's still believable, but it's a little surprising. Yeah, there's no end credits thing. Just checking, 'cause yeah, he's 10 years older than Labrava, so she's 22. But jumping back to what I said in Ares tour around UA, we meet a character who's not actually, I don't think she's ever actually named in the manga. I can't remember. Her name is Yuyu, and well, she one of the few side characters who actually got a character page. Excuse me, at least the few that I've seen. And one of the things listed as her like is cute things, which understandable. And then you get to the little character information, and it's like she is Najire's best friend. She thinks Najire is the cutest thing in the world, which sort of implies that she has feelings for Najire. Now, it's only implied, it's never stated, so before you jump on me about that, I know it's not canon. It's just that. It surprised me when it first came out because, how do I put this politely? Of the mangas and animes that I know of, Japanese creators they tend not to lean towards the same gendered relationships or anything, again, in what I've seen and know about from the LGBT community, which is also why it was a massive shock with Magne and her friend, and Tiger. I shouldn't exclude him. Because, again, never seen trans people in an anime or manga before. Which is... I'm just listing everything I like about My Hero Academia as we get to it. Because every new thing I can go on and talk about, I'm just like, this is another thing I like about My Hero Academia. Because it's different. You can see where both sides of most arguments are coming from. You can see some representation that's not shown in others. Now, it would have been questionable had it just been Magne as the only trans character, because that being a villain might have been putting forward the wrong idea, but because Tiger is trans as well, and he's a hero, then you've got the two sides of societal's views, where some vilify and discriminate, and some, it depends on the situations around them growing up, and the fact that they've shown two, one who faced the hardships and became a villain, and one who, we don't know, didn't face hardships, but didn't face as much or wasn't as affected by it, that became a hero. And there's a lot of parallels where there are two characters that are just going, they're on the same path. They could easily be the same character, but then one event and they just go completely opposite direction. Not even branch directions where they could meet or go away. Just complete T intersection, one goes left, one goes right. And, well, I can't exactly talk about the easiest one because that's massive spoiler territory, but yeah, I like how this shows that society is not always the best, and that sometimes people aren't villains just because they want to be. They're villains because society has pushed them down and they're just lashing out at those who have, well, lashed out at them. And yeah. That ramble had nothing to do with the episode. I just sort of topic to topic to topic and yeah. But back to the episode, we got a lot of recurring background characters returning. We got a brief glimpse at what Class 1B is doing. The Mei appears to be making a mech suit or just a giant robot, but it broke. Shinzo, it wasn't shown what that class was doing, but he was shown snapping a board in half while the girl beside him just cheered on like, yes, destruction. And, yeah. But, that's all I have to say about this episode, so I'll catch you in the next one.